Hello friends, I'm here to discuss your ED, and with this regard we will discuss today chapter 8. The heading of the chapter is waste accumulation and community health. As you know, waste is the main thing which produces from our house, which is really not useful to us, and it accumulates outside our house. But really its accumulation may cause damage of the scenario, or it can damage our health. So necessary is to make the things or the waste things properly dispose. How we dispose? By the help of our system. So see, in this one we will discuss from where we have the waste and how we tackle the waste for their proper or safe disposal. So see, first one, accumulation of waste in air. Air, water, soil, these are very useful things to us. We know air, if filthy, then we damage our health as well as our outside environment. So air is required to us for breathing and other purposes. So see, inside the air, accumulation of waste inside the air may be different headings like fine particles, coarser particles, components of sulfur, nitrogen, chlorine, particulate matter, that is something which is having solid, pollutants from the industries, and chlorofluorocarbon. So one by one we will discuss all the points, okay, which is present here. So say fine particles in air. What is the fine particle in air? From where it come from? Come. So it comes from the different places where the fuel burning takes place. Burning of fuel is necessary to us because without burning of fuel, there is no energy released. So for our vehicles as well as industrial activities, we have to burn fuel either in the coal or petrol or diesel. But nowadays we have another thing, that is solar energy, by which we can consume them, and electrical hydro power. So they provide us more efficient energy and they do not have any pollution level. So fine particles come from burning areas and we have to minimize their activities, or we have to minimize them to make our air safe or pollution free or healthy. Now second one, coarser particles, small particles, that is fine particles. Now bigger than that, their diameter is bigger than the fine particles, and they also come from the area where the activities of mining, where the activities of fuel consumption takes place. So see, so coarser particles also hamper the quality of air. If that particular particles having air comes to our lungs, it also damage our lungs or make our lungs unhealthy or cause different type of respiratory disease. So for safe life, we have to make our air pure by not allowing this coarser particles or other things in the air. Now third one, that is the components of sulfur, nitrogen and chlorine. This is chlorine, Cl. So chlorine and nitrogen and sulfur, they are in gaseous form entered in the air and make some compound. These compounds are harmful to us because they damage the quality of air, and also having some other compounds in it which is really not fit for our health. And but by mixing it to other components, they also make the toxic substances. So this is the elements which cause harm to the air or damage the quality of air. Now particulate matter, see, particulate matter and coarser particles somehow same, because particulate matter is also the particles present in the air. So when you move in the dark room with a torch, if you lit the torch or switch on the torch, what happens? You will see so many fine particles or so many particles are moving in the air. What is this? This is the things which is present in the air. We can't see them properly, but really this is present, and this may harm our nature. This may harm our air quality. So necessary to minimize them by how? By making the things proper, by making means you are able to minimize them by making your house dust free, making your house or outside the house you should plant more and more trees. They can absorb the dust particles from outside. Pollutants from industries. See, all the industries have their own activities, and finally they have their product, but in between the raw material to product there is so many processing takes place. So this processing hamper the environments by emitting some pollutants in air. Sometimes they also having some liquid things which we will discuss in the next accumulation in waste in water in that section. So here pollution of air, pollutants in air come from the industry. Really you seen the chimneys of the industries or factories, they have dust or they have smoke coming out from them, and really this will happen because they burn the fuel in it for the consumption of energy. So it is necessary that they can consume them, they can produce them, they can do their activities of their own for the betterment of the and economic benefit of the country as well as the industries. But at the same time this pollution or the pollutants should be protected or should be take in mind that it should not be released in the air directly. So we should make them filter, or there are so many devices by which we can remove the pollutants level of the air when it come out from the factories. So wet scrubbers, so some other banting the chimneys at different angles may reduce the level of pollutants in the air. So if we equipped our factory, our industry in these things, then after it is easy to tackle the things and our development is also not hampered. Now the next one, that is chlorofluorocarbon. You heard chlorofluorocarbon, in short we can say CFCs. CFCs are the gaseous substances which emitted from the coolants, refrigerator and other coolant cooling systems are able to, means they can produce these things, and aerosol as well as the foam, it means shaving foam, shaving cream and your perfume, deodorant, all are having CFCs, and CFC is directly related to the depletion of ozone, depletion of ozone layer. You know ozone is very useful to us. Ozone is a safety layer which protect us from the harmful ultraviolet rays. If ozone is not present, okay, as a safety layer, the UV rays comes to us and they may cause different type of skin cancer and different type of diseases, eye irritation like that. So necessary to minimize the emission of chlorofluorocarbon in the air or in the environments and to protect our ozone, the safety layer. Now we discuss. So if the air become fresh, the breathing is healthier and our health become good. This is the things we should keep in mind, that air should not be polluted from any things. If we do industrial activities, we have to take in mind, or we have to keep in mind, that we should not release the pollutants, we should not release the toxic gases in the air which hamper the quality of air for our breathing. Now see accumulation of waste in water. You know water is also very important to us, and we use water for our different activities like domestic activities from in our house, after that industries, after that irrigation. So many activities we do with the water. If the quality of water is not fit or not good, not healthy, what happens? These things become damaged. Means waterborne disease, you heard the name. Waterborne disease, so many diseases, or we can say 65% to more of diseases are waterborne diseases. So they come to us or our body due to unhealthy or due to contaminated water or polluted water. So sewage system, sewage is the main waste generating place which hamper the quality of water. Sewage, that is drain which come from the city or town and then directly pour in the water bodies. Really, this is not a good habit to pour sewage water in the water bodies or natural water bodies. So necessary to treat them before pouring it to the water bodies. How we treat? That is called sewage treatment plant. Sewage treatment plant. These sewage treatment plants can treat the water. Either if they are acidic, they treat with base and make them neutral. If it is basic, then treat with the acid and make them neutral. After making neutral, making them neutral, they will release it. Or before making this neutral, they have to filter them, they have to chlorinate them, then after it is fit for the environment. So sewage treatment plants should be planted in every town where the water come out, and then after treating it will send to the water bodies. Now chemicals, nowadays we use so many chemicals in every part of our life. Where? In agriculture, you know, discuss the agriculture, that is a fertilizers, pesticides, weedicides, rodenticides. You know, these are the requirement of our farmers. Without fertilizer, without pesticide, without these chemicals, they can't do the agriculture activities. So these fertilizers, chemical substances, may hamper the quality of water, because ultimately we pour it, we spray the pesticides on the crop, and finally after draining, after leaching, after all, it will move to the water bodies and make the water filthy regarding the chemical accumulation in it. Now water become filthy, or means water having some chemicals, dirty substances in it. So this particular activities make the serious problem, that is called biomagnification. Biomagnification, it means the accumulation of chemical substances gradually in the living food chain, or we can say environmental food chain. They come from the non-living things to living things, abiotic to biotic things, and finally the top consumers having maximum concentration of these substances in it. So this is the chemical substances which emitted not only in the agricultural activities, it also from our home also. See, we use phenyl, DDT, or we use different type of disinfectant in our house. We also use the soap, shampoos. These things also create chemical pollution or make the water chemically polluted. Now sediments, some insoluble substances present inside the water, they will settle down in the bottom of the container or the place where they move. So these sediments also have some bad impact to the water. If sediment are present in water, they are not potable or they are not healthy. So we should remove them by sedimentation and decantation process, then after it will used, or then after it will be proceed to the water bodies. Now radioactive substances, new trends are there. Radioactive substances are radium, polonium, uranium. These are the radioactive substances. They are also having some bad impact to the water bodies, एंड मेक द वाटर फिल्दी और मेक द वाटर अनफिट फॉर आवर कॉमन यूज. नाउ वी डिस्कस अबाउट द एक्युमुलेशन ऑफ वेस्ट इन लिविंग सब्सटेंसेस. सी इन सॉरी लैंड दिस वन लैंड एक्युमुलेशन ऑफ वेस्ट इन ऑन लैंड. हाउ सी लैंड ऑल द एक्टिविटीज आवर ऑन एक्टिविटीज डन ऑन द लैंड. सो दिस इज वेरी ईजी टू से दैट लैंड इज द मेन प्लेटफॉर्म on which we do all our activities of our daily life. So land is also polluted or it is also means accumulation of our own waste on the land, we can throw it. So domestic sources, agricultural sources, building and demolition sources, industrial sources, commercial sources, mining sources, hospital and pathological center, so they are means land, our land means accumulate waste from these sources. And really this is the things which we should keep in mind, that when we throw degradable things outside the house, it is not more and more negative, but when we throw non-degradable substances outside our house, this is very much fatal to us or to the land. Why? Because that will not degrade, and due to their non-degradable nature, they will stay on earth, on land for longer time. So they cause harm. They are not friendly. They are not eco-friendly with the nature and make the nature or the land damage. Regarding their accumulation on land will hamper the quality of soil as well as their fertility. So the accumulation of waste on land leads to causes serious hazards to community health, and its bad impact also takes place in the water bodies and family to underground water sources. Means when suppose this is the land, and you know inside the land there is the underground water. If you pour dirty substances in it, or it has chemical other things, so seepage of water will lead these chemical substances to the water bodies or underground water and hamper the quality of underground water as well. So this is necessary to make our underground water safe by not throwing the things on it which is harmful. Now accumulation of waste in living system. See, in our body, so we can say bodies of plants, animals and microorganisms may be called the living system because they have the capability to do physiological activities of their own in their life. So this is the things different parts of environments enter into living systems goes on increasing gradually. So many things which we take from the nature, that will increase the amount of chemical substances, useful substances, harmful substances in our body, and finally it hamper our health as well as our physiological activities of our organs, internal organs. How to check accumulation of waste? Means it is necessary to think that how we check it, because without thinking we can't do betterment of our environment. So for betterment we have to discuss, we have to know that how these things become proper, how these things become controlled. So see, community health will damage if there is the things which is really not fit for the environment. So if your air, if you living there where air is not good, water is not fit for drinking or not potable, and we can say the land is also polluted, then you are unable to live there in hygienic or healthy condition. So you have to put stress to remove that things, or to settle that things, or to make that things safe means in your neighboring areas. Otherwise the time come when the things become out of control and we are unable to make the things healthier if we try. Now see, If you want to make yourself healthy, what you do? You have to face the things, that is, we should take balanced diet, we should do regular exercise, personal and community hygiene should be there, and consumption of pollution free water, air, and live on land which are healthier or environmentally boost. So relaxation, physical exercise and good habits should be there to make our health good, and personal community health should be uplifted. How? By different ways, to aware the people who living nearby you and they are not educated, to aware them that you should live healthily. If you want to live healthily, you have to think about the waste generation of your own. You have to make the waste or dispose the waste in proper way, otherwise you will be suffer from the bad impact of that waste. So waste and community health, if there is, suppose your colony having so much waste is there, so if there is so much waste, what happens? The outside area where you live is not healthy, it is filthy because of the bad smell, because of the overflooded in the draining system or sewage system. So this make your outside unfit for living, and gradually if you do not care of, if your society do not care on them, what happens? After some times your society will be very much damage with the ill effect, or we can say the unhygienic condition of the area. So maintain supply of, see what should be maintained in the society which want to become healthy, that is the maintenance of supply of clean drinking water, maintenance of supply of disposal of waste. So proper waste disposal, clean drinking water is required for the activity. Arrangement and maintenance of the green parks and rock gardens. So see, if there is park nearby, okay, so what happens? They will provide us the fresh air. So this is necessary to us. Second thing, next thing, that is arrangement of gym, stadium and fields of the public sports. So many, these are the different type of recreational activities which makes us fit or healthy, and our life become engaged in this activity. Running of campaigns for eradication of diseases, like different type of diseases which are fatal, and our government, state government, central government, as well as the WHO, World Health Organization, also take them seriously, and time to time they try to eradicate the diseases from our society. So many diseases are eradicated easily. So sanitation and its importance should be known by all of the inhabitants of living places. So this is the way by which we can make ourselves healthy by settling of our waste accumulation nearby our houses as well as our living areas. So this is the chapter, and I think you understood, and you should also take care of your own home waste and dispose them properly, mainly the non-biodegradable waste. Okay, thank you.